It's not an easy road. How many see the glamour and the guitar, so them think I better rose. Me say,
ooh, it's like we're transferring now off of your analog system. Cause yeah, we originally bounce the tune live and direct and big analog system over here. You can see the big dub plate that must spin. And then we're going to transfer it over into the Pro Tools. And we're transferring into the Pro Tools. So it's not something we literally built in the Pro Tools. Yeah? We're transferring it into the Pro Tools. And we're going to make a bigger job of the bigger sound.
Yes, Lydie. That the tip say. And the main reason why it's kind in the Pro Tools now is because of editing. Okay? Can edit much better over there than over there. So that's another reason why we're switching now from analog to pro.
Do you remember the days when we had to do editing on analog?
Yes.
Just tell the people what was involved and how much headache it caused.
All right, then, let's show this little board. We have this board here where you line up your tape and you splice it. You get a very sharp, sharp razor blade. Then you take the tape and you lay it across here. You mark it with a piece of white chalk so you know, say, this is the part where you're going to cut. Then you make sure that you slip and slide and get the right part of the tape. And then you find the second part of the tape where you're going to have to cut out and join the tape back. And then you splice your tape, come back, find a piece of tape and just seal it up. And go on, it take long, I admit.
Digital win on that side.
A headache, I think you'll agree.
Digital win that side, yeah. Digital win that side. But, analog of the soul.
Alright. Another thing where I think analog kind of like loses on just a touch, right? See them things here? Now, on paper, right? On paper, the quality doesn't change on them things. But I can take 250 tunes of that and it doesn't even create a dent in my pocket. You carry 250 tunes on this?
You need a warehouse.
You need a warehouse, mate.
Well, the G vibes fad hunter and Leroy Simmons from the new face crew. Well, respect you, sweetie. I reach Chucky Star and Starky Banton from Northwest 10. You see, we respect them. Anna Marie, Sylvia Tella, and Paletaja. Rafael up in the group, I wear them call sister. Levi Roots and me good friend, Betty McLean. We're all a part of the UK since. So give me the reggae.
England Yard Foreign, kick up!
Yeah, worldwide. Yeah.
Yes, you see, that's what you call bad engineering. Yeah? He's recorded something on track 8 and he didn't put it on the track sheet.
No.
Yeah? But what's happened now is that another engineer from Stingray Recording, i.e. Dilly, has exposed him. Okay? Respect.
Ladies and gentlemen, lesson number one, how you correctly fill out a track sheet as described by Mr. G Vibes.
Firstly, you put on your date of the track, then engineer, title of song, the artist, the producers, what track number you are on the tape. Then from tracks 1 to 24, you fill in the sound accordingly. See, so today we've put some harmonies on the tune with Lloyd Brown. So he's used, what's it, 6 tracks? So this is the final track he used today, which is track 23.
Him greedy.
See? I just made everybody know it was Lloyd. I just put his name in big writing along the bottom here.
And you can add G-Vibes on there.
Oh, right? Yes, I can get put in there somewhere. Yes. We're doing something.
But if any mistake making, now I go see him name on it.
Now I go see
my
edit.
Yeah.
You know,
I didn't
name it, I go see
it. I didn't name it. Some strings so from Greg.
We're going to go back to Lloyd Brown now, is it? Yeah? Yeah, I think we're going back to you, Mr. Brown. Yeah. I'm sure there's some more harmony tracks somewhere along the line here for you to complete. And we'll be going this time straight to Pro Tools. So we're going to slight compression to your voice here.
No. But just a little bit. No. Right. Like I said before, right? When the tune is finished and dispensed with, the most simplest thing you can do on digital.
Yep.
Please demonstrate for me, Diddy, please. Just press.
All I've got to do now is just put two tracks in so we can hear everything back through the monitors. Two tracks only. Only two tracks. It's called a stereo run here. There you go. That's what we just copied. And that's everything playing like a record already, basically, without a mix. Yeah, so we're going to have Mr. Lloyd Brown now onto the track to complete some more harmony tracks because we run out of space on the analog system. We've only got 24 over there, but we've got 64 over here. So there's a lot of difference.
64.
Yeah.
Now, if you just wanted to just finish the tune,
yeah,
right, and put it away,
yep,
on a computer,
yep,
what would you do?
Well, there's various ways. The easiest way is we're gonna mix it in the computer and store it on the computer, all the mixes. And that's the easiest thing to do, because when it comes to any little additional to the track, it's just a matter of adding to what's there, whether it's mixed or not. So it's just simple.
Hold it right there, G-Vibe. I just want the people to see the difference, right? The difference in packing up a tune. How much does that weigh?
About 3 pounds, 4 pounds. Okay, more?
A bag of sugar weighs 2 pounds. This weighs more than 2 pounds. Stop lying to the people, Lem.
What about 4 bags
right,
of sugar?
4.5 pounds.
Yeah.
4.5 pounds, 5 pounds. And how many tunes can you put on that?
You can get 8 4-minute tunes, roughly.
8 4-minute tunes.
Like
so we're
that.
Talking about a 2/3 of an album, right?
Yeah.
Okay. How many tunes can you put on that computer there?
Wow. Well, I tell you, it can be numerous amounts. It depends on all to do with the hard drive.
Pick a figure.
20,000. That's a little bit.
20,000,
a little bit,
as said by Dilly. I didn't say it, he said it.
20,000, a little something. We'll get the bigger the hard drive is, the more memory.
All right, let's just reiterate on that. 20,000 on that.
Yeah.
Eight. Seven to eight.
Seven to eight.
Depending on the length of your track.
Just in case you never heard, right?
Yeah, 20,000.
Seven to eight, depending on the length of the track.
You do the maths.
You know, Amlock.
Yes, Amlock.
Plays bass for Steel
Pulse. Reggae Revolution, yeah.
Yeah, he came to do a document. He filmed me for a documentary the other day as well. Yeah, he's doing his own thing, and he was doing exactly what you're doing there. Everybody, I make documentary now. But it's all right. We have to spread the message, innit?
Okay. You've got a lot of work to do around here.
Okay.
I tell you what, let me interview you.
Okay.
Yeah. So, Mr. Brown, excuse me. So, what is it like doing harmony in this studio here?
It's a blessing.
What do you want? The PG version or you want the 18 version?
Okay, well.
The PG version is a pleasure. Yeah. It's a pleasure. The 18 version is a piece of. What can I tell
so they
you?
Got two versions.
Two
here.
Versions.
That's very
here.
Good.
But it's always a pleasure, yeah. And it's even more of a pleasure when I'm doing it amongst my family.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
That's the way it
makes
goes.
The work much easier and lighter, and you know what I mean? Yeah, man.